What if I told you that rheumatoid arthritis might actually start in your gut, not your joints? And what if those trillions of teeny tiny microbes living in your gut are playing a much bigger role in your joint pain than you ever realized? In this video, I will explain how your gut microbiome interacts with your immune system and could be triggering your rheumatoid arthritis pain. I will also share some powerful gut healing strategies that might be just the key to quiet the pain and reclaim your life that you have been missing. So stay with me until the end because you will discover something that could change everything for you. I am Dr. Diana Girnita, a board-certified rheumatologist with more than 15 years of clinical and research experience. That is treating patients with rheumatoid arthritis every day. What is the gut microbiome? You might think that humans are the dominant force on Earth, in control of everything happening around us. But here is the truth. We are actually the newcomers. For 3.5 billion years, microorganisms have been the true rulers of our planet. And while our bodies are made up to roughly 30 trillion human cells, we live side by side with about 38 trillion bacteria on our skin and over 100 trillion microbes in our gut. And in fact, there are around 1,000 different species of microbes in our gut alone. So your gut isn't just the place where food goes in and out. It's the largest interface between the outside world and your body. Inside, you will find a mix of bacteria, fungi, parasites, and even viruses, all together forming what we call the microbiome. Here is something fascinating. Your gut microbiome is unique to you. No one on this planet has the same, even if you eat the same food as your family. Even though you may share the same household, your microbes are different from your siblings, from your parents, or even from your spouse. But these microbes are doing much more than just hanging around. They are working hard to support your health, because they can produce essential vitamins like vitamin B, vitamin K, and they are responsible for creating 95% of your serotonin, which is the happy hormone. But it's not just about happiness, because these microbes also communicate with your immune system, letting it know when it's something missing. They can produce substances that we call short-chain fatty acids, and they will help you reduce inflammation and regulate your feeling of hunger. That is why it's so important to keep your gut microbiome in a balance. When things go wrong, this imbalance, we call it dysbiosis, and it can contribute to autoimmune diseases like rheumatoid arthritis. I often tell my patients that their gut is like the second brain because it's in constant communication with your mind. The connection between your gut and the brain is very deep, and they can hold on conversations again and again through the vagus nerve, which is a long and complex cranial nerve that connects your brain to the vital organs, like your heart, your lungs, and your gut. And this nerve will send signals both ways, which is why chronic stress can negatively impact your gut. Now also, neurotransmitters are the brain's way to communicate through the vagus nerve, and they control your emotions, your feelings, and overall well-being. For instance, the serotonin that is produced in your gut will travel through the vagus nerve to your brain, affecting your mood. So literally, a happy gut means a happier brain. Now let's dive deeper into how the gut will influence your immune system. because your gut and immune system are partners in crime. Did you know that almost 70% of your immune system lives in your gut? That means that your gut isn't just for digesting food. It will also protect your body from getting sick. Now, inside your gut are those trillions of tiny microbes. And there are good bacteria and bad bacteria. But the good bacteria aren't just there to help break down the food. They're also going to talk to your immune system every day. And when this teamwork is doing well, your body can handle threats without going overboard. But when the gut is out of balance, these things can go wrong. Your gut lining acts like a wall, keeping harmful stuff out of your bloodstream. But if your gut bacteria don't get the food that they need, like fiber, they start eating away that wall. And this would lead to what is called the leaky gut, where harmful toxins will slip through your blood, will increase inflammation, and will possibly trigger diseases like rheumatoid arthritis. And our modern life can make things worse. Those processed foods, antibiotics, and even the common painkillers like ibuprofen can harm your gut bacteria. And they will reduce the number of the good microbes, and they will also damage the gut lining. And that will make your immune system weaker and more likely to overreact. Now, people in less industrialized parts of the world, they tend to have more types of gut bacteria, and that will help them stay healthier. But in places where we live, where the diets are low in fiber and very high in sugar, we often see more cases of autoimmune diseases, including rheumatoid arthritis. So how does all of this connect to joint pain and rheumatoid arthritis? Let's dive into the next level. The gut and rheumatoid arthritis connection. As a rheumatologist, I've had this discussion many times with my patients with rheumatoid arthritis, and everything is backed by science. More and more research shows that an imbalanced gut, known as dysbiosis, play a major role in triggering and actually worsening rheumatoid arthritis. And here it is something surprising. It doesn't always start in the gut. Sometimes it starts in your mouth. A bacteria that is called Porphyromonas gingivalis, linked to gum disease, is found more often in people with rheumatoid arthritis. And gum disease and rheumatoid arthritis have something in common. They both involve attacking its own bone. This connection tells us that inflammation can start in one part of the body and then it will impact another part. Now let's go back to the gut. In rheumatoid arthritis patients, scientists have found out that there are more certain bad bacteria like Colinsella or Prevotella copri, and those were not usually present in healthy people. And these bad bacteria can damage the gut lining and it will cause what we know as leaky gut. When that lining, that protective barrier of your gut breaks down, then toxins will leak into the bloodstream. And this will keep your immune system constantly on the edge, which will trigger more joint pain and inflammation. Now, in short, when your gut bacteria are out of balance with too many harmful ones, too many bad bacteria, and not enough good bacteria, it will create this chronic inflammation. And that inflammation is what it will fuel rheumatoid arthritis symptoms like pain, swelling, and stiffness. But here it is the good news. There are ways to heal the gut, calm down your immune system, and I'm going to share them in the next part of the video. I think this is very exciting because you can restore the balance of your gut and you can ease your rheumatoid arthritis symptoms with these right strategies. Yes, medications can help, but lifestyle changes are the real game changer. research from 2022 showed that just 2 weeks on a Mediterranean-style diet, which is rich in whole grains, leafy greens, oily fish, nuts, and avocados, can begin to shift your gut bacteria in a healthy direction. And people reported feeling less pain and inflammation. And I have seen this with my own patients. Those who change how they eat and how they live, they often feel better, they need fewer medications, and they gain that sense of control again. And now let me give you some actionable steps that you can take today to support your gut. Number one, eat to nourish your microbiome. Fill your plate with fiber-rich foods like veggies, fruits, whole grains, legumes, because those will feed the good bacteria of your gut. And try to reduce the processed foods, the sugar, and the red meat, because they can throw off your gut balance. Number two, be gentle with medications. There are some medications like antibiotics or non-steroidal anti-inflammatory medication like ibuprofen that can disrupt your gut. You should not stop them on your own, but you should speak with your doctor about what are the safer options and what are other ways to protect your gut if they are necessary. And number three, care for your whole self, because your gut responds to more than just the food. Good sleep, regular movement, and stress management are very powerful tools to reduce inflammation and support your healing from inside out. If you want to learn more about the connection between the gut and the immune system and more actionable steps to heal your gut, I have laid them in my book, Thriving with Rheumatoid Arthritis. I know these actionable steps will help you feel better, heal faster, you can reach remission sooner, and you can even cut down on your medication. In a way, it's like having me as your rheumatologist right there on your side. So if you're interested, grab a copy from Amazon and start your journey towards feeling better and actually thriving with rheumatoid arthritis. And if you do get the book, don't forget to send me your comments and tell me how do you feel after you implemented these steps. And now that you know what is the connection between your gut microbiome and rheumatoid arthritis, I think it's time to learn what are the best supplements that can really help your rheumatoid arthritis. Because if you don't know them, I bet you're wasting tons of money and you will continue to suffer in pain. And you find everything in this next video.